So in continuation with fibula, just now as you have studied the theoretical aspects, I would like to show you the bone. Okay, I will help you to side determinant. Okay, let us see the side determination. Okay, let me stop this for some time. So see here, see this is the upper end of the bone. So upper end of the bone is showing the styloid process, and superiorly I've shaded with the pink color over here, chaplis, that is the articular facet, which is actually articulating with the lateral aspect of the tibia bone on the shaft to form superior tibiofibular joint. Okay, styloid process and the articular facet we have. Neck is very like prone. I told you we have common peroneal nerve here dividing into superficial and deep peroneal nerve, which is prone for fractures. Then we have shaft with three borders and three surfaces. And then side determination, you have to check for the lower end, which has triangular articular facet, which is articulating with the talus bone. Similar triangular articular facet of the talus bone to form ankle joint. Behind we have the mandibular fossa. Okay, that means posteriorly we have the mandibular fossa. Okay, that's how. So triangular articular facet anteriorly and mandibular fossa behind. Head pointed and styloid process and articular facet superior. This will help us to determine the side. So this is right side. Suppose if I get confused and if I hold the bone like this, malleolar fossa is coming anteriorly, it is wrong. Malleolar fossa should come always behind the triangular. This is the triangular facet marked with chaplis, and behind you have the malleolar fossa. Okay. Try to have your own bones and try to appreciate them. This whole thing is shaft, I told you. See, this is the right bone, right? So in the right bone, we have anterior border, then we have posterior border and medial border. Medial border is also called as interosseous border, which is quite sharp. Rest of the borders are more or less arbitrary. Then we have near the midline, we have the medial surface. Then we have away from midline, we have the medial surface. Behind, we have the posterior surface. Okay, so this everything has been discussed in the PowerPoint, isn't it? So the same thing, side determination, it is slightly expanded, isn't it? I said it is expanded in all directions, and it has like head has styloid process. And lower end, I said it has a triangular articular facet anteriorly and mandibular fossa posteriorly. So the strong features we have discussed just now, including ossification and clinical aspect, fracture epidemic, it may lead to foot drop because it may damage common peroneal. Okay? Keep studying. Thank you.